Get ready to match the stars. Nipsey Russell, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Patty Duke-Aston, Richard Dawson, from the Betty White Show, Betty White, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now, here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Rivers.
Thank you, friends. Thank you for joining us, and thank you for joining us. My, don't you, you really look young in person.
We're a happy group.
Cutie.
Don't they all they tell you that all the time?
Really?
Yes.
What about you sit there and die?
No, they tell me that all the time. You look so much younger in person.
They don't tell me that.
Honey, you look cute no matter what.
They do. All right, now let's say hello to our two players, Doris Martinez and Beth Martin.
That's it. Doris has won one game.
Stubbed her toe a little bit on the audience super match there and has a total of $350.
Thank
and
you.
That's better than nothing.
That's right.
They look younger in
Absolutely.
Person, too.
They do look younger in person, don't they? Now, she's been challenged by Beth Martin here, who's done very well. She's matched four celebrities in the first round, which is quite unusual. And we're going to begin with the second and final round right after we do a little business for you. Here we go. All right. A or B, Beth Martin?
A.
A it is. Now, only two people play, Brett and Charles. This is especially for you.
Now for the liar's side of the news.
Well, you matched in the first round. And this is the second round. Larry said to the psychiatrist, "My wife needs help. Last night I confessed that I was a little chicken, and she tried to blank me." Larry said to the psychiatrist, "My wife needs help. Last night I confessed that I was a little chicken, and she tried to blank me." Ready?
Little chicken.
A little chicken. Is that another chicken, Joe?
My wife. Last night I confessed that I was a little chicken.
Yes.
And she tried to blank me. Now that's not very hard.
Not at all.
What?
This one terrific right. answer.
Well, there's several good answers. Just choose the one you think Beth Martin's going to write down on the card, and she will do vice versa.
No matter how loud a rooster may crow, it's the hen who delivers the goods.
Put it in the slot when you're finished.
Oh, dear, he's fading
here. Deck of cards, we could do a fast game of gin rummy while they're playing over there. Oh, they're ready now. Larry said to the psychiatrist, "My wife needs help. Last night I confessed that I was a little chicken. She tried to blank me."
Peck me?
Peck me.
Yeah,
I was a little chicken. Not that she was a little chicken. You got mixed up there. All right, Beth, I don't think it's going to occur, but we've got to go through the motions here anyway.
You never can tell from where you sit with the man in the balcony. He's going to spit, but not this time. I tried to stuff him.
Stuff me? Okay, is one. Whatever you do with a chicken.
I went with the old standby cook.
Well, you know, any of the things there, she tried to... fry me, you know, roast me.
Right.
Pluck me.
I confessed I was... Pluck me, right? I confessed I was a little chicken, and my wife tried to... Well, never mind. It's all over anyway. Hello, Doris.
Hi, Jane. How are you?
Three to tie, four to win.
Right.
The baseball player said... That other... Ah, shut up. Thank you, sir. Thank you for your inquiry.
Kill the umpire.
The baseball player said, "That other team's first baseman is strange. After he tagged me on the shoulder, he said... blank."
Stop.
After he tapped me on the shoulder, he said blank.
One answer.
The other
right.
That other team's first baseman is strange. After he tapped me on the shoulder, he said blank.
I already have my answer.
Good.
He's putting his over there as if I was going to take it.
I've got a good one.
Oh, I like that.
Yeah. You know, I almost said that.
After he tagged me on the shoulder, he said.
We're all ready.
Hello, Doris.
Hello.
Got an answer ready?
I'm going to try.
The other team's first baseman is strange. After he tagged me on the shoulder, he said.
Let's dance.
Let's dance. Well, that
that was one of the possibilities there. Who does not play?
Nipsey.
Nipsey does not play. Brett, what do you do?
Oh, I had such a good answer.
I said, you're it.
You're it, yeah. That's what happens when you play tag. He says, you're it. You're it. You're it now.
What's so strange about that?
Tag, now you chase me.
Well,
you're
baseball,
it.
You see.
Oh.
You'll be all right in the morning. Just take
Dr. Humphreys. I mean, the doctor shouldn't stand in the wings when there's so much going on here.
Right.
What did she say? Let's dance?
Yes.
That's so silly. It's may I have the next day.
Aha! Thank you. Going now, 42.
I'm sticking my ass where I really need it.
It would be strange if on a baseball field the guy tagged me and says, you're it. That would be strange.
And dancing is not?
Well, dancing is strange, too.
What if he said, I love you, let's dance?
He said, I love you. He wouldn't dance at all.
They already danced.
Yeah. What do you say? You got a match of two remaining ones to stay in the game.
I love you.
I love you. What do you have, Betty?
May I have
a dance? So that means Beth wins. Don't go away. Doris, I'm glad you won some money.
Thank you, Gene. It's been a pleasure being here.
Thank you. Doris Martinez, ladies and gentlemen,
thank
leading
you.
With $350. Your mom is putting her off.
Thank you very much.
Just for you. Nice work. No. Now we're ready to carry on here. This is the first game that Beth Martin has won. She could win a big bundle of money here. Beth, good luck to you. You want to do this now? Oh, all right. Before we go on with Beth Martin here, I just want to point out to all assembled on this day that week after next, November 7th, the CBS is changing the time of Match Game 77. And beginning on that day, we will be seen at 11 a.m. in the East and 10 a.m. in the West and Midwest. And we will be following The Price is Right. So that's beginning November 7th. That's week after next. And we hope that all of you who are watching at this time will be able to watch at that time, too. Now, let us be carry on here. Joel, just take Doris Martinez's name off there and put Beth Martin's name up there in case I forget who Beth Martin is. Which is not very likely, but it could happen. Not too long ago, Beth, we had a bunch of people in the room, and we polled them, and we said, give us your best response to this. Flag blank. If you match the answer that they wrote down most frequently, we will give you $500 additional. If you match their second most popular answer, you get $250. And then if you match their third, you get $100. And three of our six celebrities will help you, Beth.
Richard.
Flag Day.
Flag Day. Richard will help you.
Betty.
Betty White, have you got an answer for this one?
Flagpole. I'm not being ethnic. Flagpole.
Flagpole. All right. Nipsey.
What I am proud to be, a flag waver.
Flag waver.
Right.
So those are the three, Beth. Flag waver, flagpole, and flag day. It's your option now to choose one of those or give us one of your own.
Flag Day.
Flag Day is what you want. I think they think you're right. We'll find out if you are as we begin down at the bottom and reveal the $100 response. Flag of the U.S. of A. is the first one there. All right, let's see what's under the $250 number. Flag Day, you've got it, Beth. That's another $250 for you. Got a total of $350 now. Let's see. Flagpole, flag waver. What do you think?
Flagpole!
Pole. All right, slide it, please. Flag pole. All right. I'm glad you won something, Beth. And more important, you're going to play for 10 times that amount now, or $2,500. And we'll give you the money if you'll match one celebrity exactly.
Richard.
Okay, here we go with Richard. Good luck to you. Get your ESP flowing to him, because he's got his ESP flowing to you, or something is flowing to you from him. I can feel it in the air. Here it is. Blank Eddie. That's E-D-D-I-E. Blank Eddie. Blank Eddie. All right. Give us the answer that Richard has written on the card, and we give you $2,500, Beth. What do you say, Blank Eddie?
Nelson Eddie.
You don't like that?
Can't think of anything else.
Can't think of anything besides Nelson Eddie?
Well, he spells his name E-D-D-Y, doesn't he?
Right.
Yeah. Well, all right, let's find out. Face your accuser there. Richard, she says Nelson Eddy will match you, but she doesn't like the answer.
Neither do I.
Ah! Okay. Hello, Bill.
How are you?
I'm all right. How are you, sir?
Just fine, and thank you.
Where are you from, Bill?
I'm from Kansas, the Sunflower State.
No kidding. That's a beautiful place.
Thank you.
And are you vacationing here?
Yes, I am.
What do you do for a living?
All right, I'm in marketing.
Marketing?
Right, we're in chemical sales.
I see. All right, you married?
Yes, I am.
Any kids?
Yes, two.
What are their names?
Bridget, Heather.
Bridget and Heather.
Right.
Two boys, huh? How old are they, Bridget and Heather?
Are 17 and 10.
17 and 10. Okay, Bill Belcher, good luck to you, sir.
Thank
Here
you.
Here we go. You may have A or B.
B for Belcher.
B for Belcher. Now, while you are here, not one word will cross my lips about your last name. I'm not going to do it. I know you're tired of it all your life. You've been hearing it. Not from me, Bill. Here it is.
Thank heaven. Tacky, tacky, tacky.
Don't say tacky. We're going to have a little meeting about those names of Bridget and Heather.
Larry ran out of hamburger meat.
Oh.
So he ran his blank through the grinder.
It's not catching. I just can't bring myself to do it.
Won't you come up?
All right, Bill, if you're ready.
Five long.
Larry ran out of hamburger meat, so he ran his blank through the grinder.
He ran his wife through the...
His wife through the grinder. I think Bill is getting with it in a hurry here, because that seems to be a pretty good response. What do you say?
Well, I don't know Larry's wife, and maybe she was, but I say he ran his dog.
Oh!
Look how upset you-know-who is getting.
No.
Isn't that funny? She got upset when she ran his dog through it. Didn't matter if it was his wife.
True. His wife was a dog.
Here's the thing. No, I mean for your eyes. You don't need him there. All right, what do you say?
She already has a bust full of those.
That's right.
I say, in honor of the Betty White show.
Yes.
And Betty White dog.
Oh. Show us your wife, Charles.
It was a little Pekingese, and the last words were, ooh, that's smart.
Bill, I thought you were going to capture the whole bunch with that answer.
Hot dog, hamburger.
There. No dogs down here, huh? Oh, there's one for you, Bill.
In the words of Henny Youngman, take my dog, please.
Take my wife, exactly. Super Bill. Now, you wouldn't expect Betty White to say dog of all people.
Your money or your wife?
Yeah.
I'm thinking it over.
Well done, Bill. Yours will be long in a moment. Right now, we want to do a little business with you. All right, here we go. The other half of round one. Beth Martin, this is your question. Listen carefully. The prisoner said...
Mm-mm, we're in jail again.
This prison is so tough if you're bad... As punishment, they lock you in a room with a television set and make you watch blank. That's how tough this prison is. You're bad. They lock you in a room with a television set and make you watch blank.
Oh, I'm sorry.
All right.
I never have them very neat.
It's okay. Perfectly all right. Ready?
He may be, but then again, he may not.
Desperation does terrible things to him.
Isn't okay, that then. Music adorable and catchy?
Wonderful. Prisoner said this prison is so tough, if you're bad as punishment, they lock you in a room with a television set and make you watch...
Soap operas?
Soap operas.
That's terrible.
The idea here would be, Beth, anything, you know, that would be considered a rotten show, I suppose. What do you say, Nipsey?
It's so bad they lock you up and make you watch the Gong Show.
Let's embrace him, honey.
I agree with you.
Indeed.
How about you?
I'm sick of people picking on us.
Right.
Oh. Hollywood Squares! Right.
Yes.
Us.
Now, I ask you, Charles, in all fairness...
I thought of that, and that's what I came up with. I thought it over Monday's new schedule. I thought of the Betty White Show. I thought of a lot of things, and I came up with... us.
Okay, Charles.
All right. And another thing, Brett and I have not had a conference about the change in time. Wasn't okayed with us. We can't just go from 2:30 to 11, 10 o'clock Central, Western, Eastern. Yeah. We have other things. We're tired of hearing about Family Feud, the Betty White Show, and Patty's movies, and Nipsey's big movie. She and I have a show that happens to go on at 11 o'clock, so we'll talk about it later on another network.
Okay.
The Brett and Chuck Show.
He really is bananas.
You want something for me?
Yes.
You want the answer too?
Oh, it's been so long since everybody's forgotten what the question is. This prison is so tough, if you're bad as punishment, they'll lock you in a room with a television set and make you watch...
Howard Cosell.
Howard Cosell.
Oh.
That would be a revolting experience.
They make you watch it twice.
Twice, oh.
As for murderers.
Prefer solitary confinement, wouldn't you, Betty?
Yes, I would. Rather than this, too, and you won't believe this, but Brett and Charles on the Best of Match. Ah.
That's getting back up over there. So there we are at the end of round one. 3-0, favor the challenger. Round two coming up. Bill, you may have A or B.
B for Belcher.
Oh, you said that last time. Here we go. Ugly Edna is so ugly. The beach when she wears flippers, she looks like a blank. Ugly Edna, so ugly. Only the top row.
Only the top row.
Only the top row. When she wears flippers, she looks like a blank. That's how ugly Ugly Edna is. There it is, Charles.
So ugly. At the beach when she wears flippers.
Start another movie in August, and you don't have time to hang around here waiting for them to finish writing. Okay, Bill. Ugly Edna is so ugly, at the beach, when she wears flippers, she looks like a blank.
A walrus.
Walrus. Walrus. Okay. Who plays? The whole top tier only. Nipsey. Right.
Well, since beauty is only skin deep and ugly is to the bone, I tend to go along with him. I hope this is acceptable as a match. I said seal or walrus.
Well, you did say walrus. So that's one for him. Brett?
After our long conference, I decided against dolphin. I did not want to be so specific, so I said fish. Now, is it walrus?
Walrus.
You got your answer there.
That's your answer to your question. Chuck?
It rhymes. Chuck, duck.
Oh, no kidding. When she wears flippers, she looks like a duck on kind of the big feet and the webs.
I was going to say an oil slick, but then Betty would be upset again.
So, Bill, you picked up one more. We've got one more question for you, but right now we have this for you.
Right on, Bill.
Join me next time, Match Game 7 on Gene Rayburn. Goodbye.
What'd you say?